10 for the 2011 year of blogging. Yes. So we're going to take you through our top 10 favorite blog moments and show you little tidbits about them and videos and everything. It's just going to be funny.
General tomfoolery.
Laugh at our general tomfoolery. All right, number 10.
Number 10. Woo! Oh, wait, we need them to do background. Charlie and the tornado. All right, I have to set this one up. We are coming home from school one day, and there has been a tornado drill, or I don't know. Anyway, there was talk of tornadoes at school. Yes. Well, this was the spring when you should have talk of tornadoes. Well, so Charlie on the way home is telling us, hey, remember back last year when we had that tornado drill? That tornado drill was the first time he'd ever had a tornado drill since coming here from Ethiopia.
They don't have tornadoes in Ethiopia.
Nor do they have tornado drills. Because he said to me, well, that day I did not know what was going on. I thought they put us all in the hallway and made us stick our butts in the air. I thought we were all going to get shots in our butts.
They do have shots in Ethiopia.
And I just completely lost it. I felt really sorry for him and thought it was hysterical all at the same time.
Number nine came from our Super Bowl party at the Millikens last year. And I know in a Baptist church you're really not supposed to dance. But the preacher's son knows how to dance. Like,
yes,
really
he does.
Good. Mr. Jacob Moore, he was breaking down and was just cracking us up. And apparently, everybody thought the music to the video was MC Hammer, and everybody thought that he was actually dancing to that music at the Milliken's house, but I can assure you that Nat Milliken doesn't typically play MC Hammer at his house. But that was just the music that was in Nicole's head when she was taping the video. But it's really funny, so watch it.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this.
Is Jason and the potty. Hence the potty. It's a picture from Lynch that we do have on the blog. And basically what happened, this was our second trip to Lynch this year. Jason and Phil and several guys went back down to help finish some work at Jesse's house that we didn't get finished in October. One of the things they had to do was install a potty. And if you've never been to Lynch, you wouldn't know this, but you could sit on a toilet in the middle of Main Street in Lynch for quite some time and never have to move because there wouldn't be any traffic. So Jason decided to test that theory out, and there you have it.
Number 7 is Lydia's homecoming. After a week of VBS and all the fun that entails, we all headed down to the airport to welcome home the Melton family and their new little girl, Lydia. And even though it was midnight and we'd all been up since, I don't know, 6 o'clock that day doing VBS, we all made it there with our I Love VBS t-shirts on, and we got lots of looks, but it was definitely one of my favorites from the blog. Number 6!
I love.
Okay, number 6 is All the Things We Love. It's a video from VBS where we had all the kids talk about all the things that they love. Justin Bieber makes an appearance a couple of times. And we thought it was one of the funniest memories from VBS.
I love Jesus!
I love dark chocolate.
I love my iPod.
I love my mommy.
I love Haley and Trent.
I love VBS.
I love Mexican food.
I love monkeys.
I love my dog, my parents, and me.
I love to sing and dance.
I like with Ashley.
I love ice cream.
I love black and yellow.
I love the Statue of Liberty.
I love Emma.
I love Justin Bieber.
I love Justin Bieber.
I love Justin Bieber!
I love Justin Bieber!
All right, what's something you absolutely love?
Coming to Vacation Bible School.
Coming to Vacation Bible School? That's awesome. Anything else you love?
No.
That's all?
I love my wife.
I like your mind. I love three more.
I love mohawks.
I love my eyes.
All right, so, oh shoot, I wasn't recording. Now do it.
I love, That's good, because it's supposed to be done, right? I love Jana. You right here.
Oh. Okay.
I love babies.
Okay.
I love having fun for Jesus.
I love 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 Jesus.
Number five came from our Lynch trip. One of the things that we do in Lynch is we take huge rolls of plastic and cover up the windows so that it helps the inside of the houses stay warm during the winter. And when we got finished with this particular house, we hiked ourselves back down the mountain to Dwayne's little tiny car and realized that our big cardboard roll that we had left over was way bigger than his car. So we had to creatively put it back in the car to get ourselves back to town. And it kind of made his car look like a roll of toilet paper.
Number four is Jana and the Train. In Lynch, another one from Lynch. In Lynch, there is an actual train engine and caboose, right?
Yes.
That's set at the park in Lynch. That's been completely restored. It's beautiful. Actually, it's a really neat place to go. Well, we stopped there with three of the younger kids who wanted to see it on our way back down into Cumberland. And Jana climbed up on the rail thing that goes around the engine so you can walk around. And I was still down on the ground. And she decided she was going to lower herself back through the rails and drop onto the ground. Not a really well thought out plan for a couple of reasons. First of all, it's way higher than she thought. And secondly, the only way to do that is to drop and let your back scrape on the metal going down. So she got herself lowered, then realized it was a really bad idea, and was just stuck there, which is what we have the picture of. Now, after the picture was taken, I laughed hysterically, did not know how to help her. The only thing I could think to do was I put my camera down and went and wrapped my arms around her around her legs and told her to drop, which would have been great, except that I've lost about 35 pounds in the last year, and the pants I was wearing are fat pants. So they didn't fit me real well anyway, so as she was shimmying down me, my pants were going down too. So there we stood on Main Street in Lynch. Her dangling from a train, me with my pants down, and her shimmying down me to get to the ground.
11
Most of the time, there's no traffic whatsoever in that place, and we turn around, and there's a white minivan full of tourists watching the train.
Choo-choo!
Choo-choo!
Blow the whistle!
Our next one is number three. And this came from Lynch also, and this you should learn anything from this, you should learn that we have a lot of fun in Lynch, and you really should just come on our next Lynch trip. This particular one happened at the playground. You know those really old playground horses that have, like, the springs on the bottom of them? Well, Nicole decided that she would get on it, and even though, as we previously mentioned, Nicole has lost 35 pounds, she still weighs enough to put the thing almost on the ground. And I don't think I have ever laughed so hard watching her on that horse going all the way back. I mean, her hair was almost touching the ground.
I had no idea I was going that low.
All the way back. And I just, that was just almost too much.
Okay, I gotta stop laughing. Nicole's lost a lot of weight, but she's gonna bite that horse. What?
I did it.
I mean, she's almost hitting the ground.
What? Number two,
up until like a month ago, I would have been my number one, hands down. But number one is funnier. It is. But number two is Jana and Roy Banks in Lynch. We were at Loaves and Fishes, which is the food ministry down there, handing out food to folks who come to get their handed out food.
Yes. They and, don't have food.
And this man pulls up in this pickup truck. He's this teeny little old man, and he's got on
with a
construction paper hat that he made
himself. Yes, he made it. Yes.
And he proceeds to tell us that he's Roy Banks, and we obviously should have heard to him.
Immediately asked me if I had heard of him.
Yes, because he's on YouTube.
Yes,
which, I mean, YouTube. Who would even think he would know what YouTube is? But yeah. He is on there. He plays the harmonica and sings old hilarious songs. And so I said, okay, can you show us what you do? And he did. And then this was inside. And then I asked him if he would come back outside and show us a little bit of what he does. And I volunteered Jana to dance with him, and it was awesome. The best part of the video is you have to watch Jana's face as she's trying to figure out, to like get cues from him to figure out what he's getting ready to do next. And there's all this, like, I don't even know
he
what
was,
it is.
I don't really think there's a pattern to the dance. He just dances and makes it up. I don't think he's used to dancing with a partner is what the real problem is.
Yes, and playing harmonica, which was pretty impressive.
Yes, he was doing both. But check I think out the I got video. A little bit of slobber on me.
Check out the video and then check him out on YouTube. He was doing
you gotta move quick, people.
This is number one. Number one, if you came to the Christmas party at Nick Moore's house, me and Nicole played Fruit Ninja, and we've never played Fruit Ninja before. But apparently it's very popular, and it was on that Kinect thing where you don't have to have any,
oh, that was yours.
You don't have to have any, remote controls or anything, you just use your body as a remote. And, Dwayne put together this super cool video, kind of like the one he's going to do right now, for us, and it was really cool. I just hit Kenny in the face with a banana. But, funny. There's really no explanation.
And sorry, Xander.
Yeah, sorry, Xander. I hit him in the face. This banana is no good anymore. Everybody is
readers. You know, the blog is a funny thing. We really started it just so people would have a place to get the answers to those questions they kept texting us, like on Wednesdays, like what's the Awana theme night, or do I serve this Sunday?
You can still text us.
Yeah, you can do that too. But we decided just to kind of make it a place for information, and it, I don't know, we like put something funny on there one time and got all these responses, and that's where it started. But we love doing it, and thank you guys for reading. That's all, folks.